My name is Kathryn. I'm 14 years old, and I live in Mount Pleasant, Michigan. I don't really know what originally put it into my head. I'm not entirely sure. I think a big part of it, though, was working and going to car shows and just seeing different things that people had built. Love at first sight, you know. It's just like this cool little sporty car that you can just drive around, and it can just be you and one other person, and it's just, I think it's a cool little car. When we first got the car home, we put it into the backyard because I wanted to get started right away, of course. And so I was literally sitting there looking at the car, and I'm like, okay, where do I start?
This is the hardest one to get. Can you see where your wear sleeve is down there?
Yeah.
Where the bottom stroke of the piston is? Mm-hmm. So you want to be just like just above that. You got it, Nello.
I got it.
All right.
We're good.
When we immerse ourselves in a big project or a problem set without even necessarily knowing why or what the outcome is, we have the opportunity to learn new things that are unlike any other opportunity.
Mm-hmm. It is. Look at that. Real close there on those two.
The project itself is creating opportunities for her to learn that she didn't set out for that to happen.
So what I'm doing right now is I'm using telescope gauges and micrometers to measure the bore of the cylinder in three different locations, top, middle, and bottom. And then I'm also measuring the diameter of the piston to make sure that my tolerance levels are where they're supposed to be.
Imagine if she kind of did this as an exercise on paper or watched someone else do it. The amount of real learning that would happen would be minimal. So it's really that, almost that diving off the cliff and into something that is really, it's risky. You know, she's spending a lot of time on this and yet she's holding it all together. And I think that's pretty amazing.
When I first started school, like all through elementary school really, I wasn't very good at math at all. Like, I had so many issues. Like, we'd do flashcards every night and I'd still just completely not understand it. And so, like, as I got older, it started to be a problem, you know, because you can't really pass school without knowing math. Then I started on this car and I could take lessons I learned from the car and how I'd used it mathematically to do and solve the problems in the classroom.
I'm not so sure it's solid.
What's not solid?
The most basic level is you're learning to learn here, so you're becoming a better learner. And your engagement around learning is higher. You're going to be more receptive and open to new forms of learning, even ones that don't especially work for you.
That's way too small. Some of the examples in my car for math is like converting metric to standard systems and just learning how to measure and place parts and to be able to understand how much tolerance you need for it, and so it helps to learn your mathematical systems. The forum, it's been a really big part of this project because it's an online place where you post comments almost like Facebook, and it's called the Penix Fierro Forum because it's pretty much all based on Fierros.
So you got this that you weld in.
Mm-hmm.
And there's some of your nice holes and your frame rail finish.
You go in and there's people working on all kinds of different projects to do with the Fierro or just sharing feedback or suggestions. Kind of like having a bigger form of a family really on the forum. So if I post just up onto my thread and be like, hey, I'm stuck, I need some help, SOS here, and so and they'll be like, all right, what are you stuck on? Let's see how I can help. Here's some suggestions.
To be able to go out and find those people, no matter where they live, who are working on cars and say, I've had that problem. I know that transmission, or this replacement part that you buy over here is not very good. This one is a better one. They're navigating a world of living knowledge. Right? It's not just book knowledge, it's real thing. And how valuable is that?
I definitely think about how school could be better if they had more interactive projects, because there are so many kids who don't get to go on and learn what they could really do because they don't have these opportunities. And so I think that if like schools could offer more interactive, more what you want to do into your classroom systems, then a lot more kids would be willing to learn, willing to go to school, and actually having a good time there, opposed to, oh my gosh, I've got this next class and I don't want to go.
The Fiero is Kathryn's car. It's her. It's that object and her are aligned.
If I'm like having a rough day at school or something, I'm like, okay, in a few hours you're gonna be home, you get to go to your shopping, you get to work, and you just get to forget everything else.